I'm Rick Emerson. Welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're here with Anna Griffin, who writes a twice-weekly column for the Oregonian. In all of this that we've been talking about, whether it's soccer, or whether it's Sam Adams, or whether it's blowing cars up downtown, lost in all of this somewhat paradoxically because it is omnipresent is the economy, which is, as you said, in the tank and is such an ongoing issue right now, affecting everybody and saturating every pore of our existence, that it can be easy to stop thinking about it. So as the second and third waves of unemployment hit Portlanders and a lot of large businesses closing down or streamlining, belt tightening, what sort of pressure is that putting on the city, either in terms of the government or resources or both?
Oh, it's putting immense pressure on. And part of the reality is we haven't even begun to really feel the impact yet. We have not seen the impact of the massive cuts that county government is having to make in social services. You're going to be seeing more homeless people. You're going to be seeing more mentally ill people who aren't getting care. You're going to be seeing more senior citizens who aren't getting care. The school system has barely begun to digest what the next school year is going to look like, how many teachers are not going to have jobs next year. We're here on the curve. It's not going to get better anytime soon. And we were already not in great shape before the recession hit. This was already a city that was still trying to figure out what it was going to be economically when it grew up, so to speak. And so it's not good.
You know, you referenced the homeless issue just now. I have to ask you, and I've lived in Portland now for well over a decade, whatever happened to Dignity Village?
Dignity Village is still there.
That was still sort of there. This encampment where the homeless, where is it located?
It's out near the airport. It's out in North Portland, and it is a freestanding, essentially tent city, although the tents are more semi-permanent structures now for homeless people who choose to live in a self-governing community, which is great for a certain segment of the homeless population. There are activists who would like to create something similar to that, a place where you can camp without the cops coming and giving you a hard time and telling you to move along, closer to downtown, which is where all the service agencies are. City government, nudged by downtown business leaders, has consistently said, no way, horrible idea.
I do realize, by the way, that I sounded a lot like Andy Rooney just
there.
Whatever happened to Dignity Village? Will anything ever get named after Cesar Chavez? It doesn't seem like it could possibly be this difficult to put someone's name on something.
The first answer is yes. Something will get named for Cesar Chavez. I am very skeptical it will ever be a street in this city. The first time around, a group of Latino activists, noting rightly that there are no monuments to Latinos or Latino Americans in a city that has a region that has an ever-increasing population of Latino immigrants, many of whom do the nasty, hard physical work that we affluent white people don't want to do anymore, wanted a street named. And they chose Interstate for a number of reasons. The process was pretty much no process at all. City leaders were shocked when people in North Portland objected to having their street renamed with no process. So everybody sort of regrouped, and the Chavez committee is back now, and they are focused on 39th Avenue. And shockingly, people on 39th Avenue would like to keep their street name. The people pushing the renaming have said, we want a street. We have asked for a street. Many other ideas have been floated. The new light rail bridge that's going to go over the Willamette, the new Columbia River crossing, community gardens across the city, Delta Park, Overlook Park. The people who want something renamed have said, no, we want a street. So in a few weeks or a few months, it's going to come back before City Council, and it's going to be very emotional, it's going to be very unpleasant, and it's hard for me to imagine that it doesn't end in just as big a fight as the last one did.
Maybe we should just start by naming a street in another state. We should just vote in Portland, you know, like Akron, Ohio. We should just decide that one of the streets is going to be Cesar Chavez Boulevard, and we'll start there, and then we'll work our way back to Portland.
Well, and it seems like a dumb thing for people who live on 39th Avenue to object to having a number changed, but people like to object to things. And it's your street, you know.
I suppose that's true. Anna Griffin from The Oregonian, thank you for joining us. We will have you back again at some point. My name is Rick Emerson, and if you find me even moderately amusing, don't forget you can hear me weekdays 5 to 9 on Rock 101 KUFO. Until next time, insert trademark catchphrase here. We will see you next Sunday right here on Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV.